If you have access to the internet, and you probably wouldn't be watching this video if you didn't, expressions like virtual reality and augmented reality have probably been popping up in your information feed. Technology is advancing faster than ever, and it's really hard to keep up with all the new terminologies. When it comes to technology, VR and AR are the domains where famous Arthur C. Clarke's quote really comes to life. He said that any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. What are virtual and augmented reality actually? What is the difference? What are they capable of? All these questions will be answered in this video. But don't worry, it's not as confusing as it sounds. Well, virtual reality and augmented reality are not really new technologies. They have existed since the 1960s. For a long time, VR and AR were a passion of a few academics and cyberpunk aficionados. But recently, due to increase in power of small computing devices, these technologies have entered mainstream markets. Thanks to rivalry of Nvidia and AMD, graphics cards are advancing exponentially. Progress of GPUs has made consumer virtual and augmented reality a reality. At first, it might seem that these are visual technologies, but visual is just part of the experience. Although an important part, audio and haptic touch elements are an integral part of the setting. The way these elements are put together is what distinguishes VR from AR. Virtual reality is a completely artificial reality composed of multidimensional computer-generated images. What does that mean? It means that everything you see, hear, and feel around you is generated by the computer. The computer presents us with the whole world that we can explore by seeing, hearing, moving, and touching in all three spatial dimensions. Augmented reality is a bit different. It starts with the real world around you and adds supplemental information to enrich the experience. This additional data can also be visual, auditive, and haptic. To put it simply, VR is Fortnite and AR is Pokemon Go. Or if you like cult movies from the previous century, VR is the digital world of Tron, a 1982 sci-fi classic, or the simulation in Matrix, and augmented reality is the world perceived by Schwarzenegger's Terminator. Even though they have existed since the 1960s, real-world applications of VR and AR are still very recent. With the largest players in the mobile market, Apple, Google, and Samsung, investing heavily in these technologies, the most significant leaps in capabilities are yet to come. We're at the beginning of a transformation that will put these technologies at the forefront of user experience in every aspect of human lives. It will change how we work, how we are entertained, how we learn, and how we communicate. The change is well underway, so get yourself a comfortable chair or a headset and enjoy the ride. Today, virtual reality is mostly used in gaming. There are special headsets and uniforms for playing these kinds of games. It's extremely immersive experience, but somewhat unusual, especially for beginners. Most people are not used to virtual worlds, and disorientation and nausea are common effects at the beginning. New high-end equipment has mostly resolved these issues. 360-degree video is another form of entertainment using VR technology. These videos are recorded using omnidirectional cameras. You have probably seen one of these on Facebook or YouTube. You can navigate the 3D world by moving the phone or tablet around. If you use a headset, navigation is done by moving your head. Besides entertainment, virtual reality is used in training and education, especially in the military, medicine, architecture, professional sports, and others. Florio, for example, is a platform using VR to teach social skills to kids with an autism spectrum disorder. Simulating the battlefield is used for training soldiers, but also for treating post-traumatic stress disorder in veterans. Whenever you need to simulate the situation from the real world, VR can be of help. On the other hand, augmented reality is used a bit differently. It doesn't create a new world, it enhances the already existing one. While VR has a standard interface, headset, and controller, AR can be accessed using different devices like glasses, headset, mobile phones, tablets, projectors, HUDs or head-up displays. You need some way to see the real world, like translucent glass or camera, and some way to put content over it, usually a translucent screen. Some of you may remember Google Glass. It was not a big success market-wise, but it stirred a lot of debate regarding AR in practice. I suppose 2013 was still too early for such technology. AR was more widely accepted when Google introduced Cardboard, a cheap device that, combined with a cell phone, could provide anybody with VR and AR experience. While much more primitive technologically than glass, it received a significantly warmer welcome from the public. And after Snapchat and Pokemon Go, AR was no longer a strange name for mobile phone users. There are two major areas of AR application today: consumer and industrial. In consumer space, the ubiquity of mobile phones provides several billion people with devices capable of producing AR experiences. In industry, specialty AR devices like headsets and glasses are used due to the higher demands regarding functionality. Prominent players in this field are Google with Glass 2 and Microsoft with HoloLens. There are rumors that Apple is working on an AR device, most probably glasses. Apple has provided developers with a software developer kit called AR Kit to make the development of AR content easier. It has been introduced in 2017 and is constantly updated. With big players like Apple, Google, Microsoft, and Samsung investing heavily in AR and VR, we can be sure that the future will be colored by these technologies. Immersive user experiences will become a standard, and you should adapt to meet higher demands from customers. Post-industrious experts have years of experience in the field and can help you make a future-ready user experience.